If you know anything about me at all, you know I love magic and I love Australians. So this is going to be good. Making his U.S. primetime debut, please welcome James Galea.
Thank you. Hello, Chicago! You know what? I only got in town yesterday, and people have been saying that they're having trouble understanding me because I talk too fast. And I had all these tricks that I wanted to do. Now I'm not so sure. So I put together this group IQ test. And depending on how you respond to that will depend on the type of tricks that I'll do for you here tonight. So what I'd like you all to do is just put your hands out so your thumbs are face up for me, just like this. Hands out. So your thumbs are face up, just like that. Very good. I can see some people back there going, I'm not doing that. Put your hands out! Love you. Okay, what I need you to do now is turn so your thumbs are facing the floor for me, just like that. Just turn so your thumbs are facing the floor. I've already lost a few of you. I don't know how to make that easier. Just turn so your thumbs are facing the floor. All right, it's going to get a little harder. I want you to put your palms together so your thumbs are still face down. Just palms together so your thumbs are face down. Just like that, ma'am. Very good. All right, now comes the tough part. What I need you to do is clench your fists so your thumbs are still face down, okay? You're doing that wrong. Just clench your fists so your thumbs are face down, yeah? Very good. Now, on the count of three, listen closely before you scream. I want you to turn so your thumbs are face up for me just like this. Ready? One, two, three. So your thumbs are face up for me, please. It's gonna be a long night. You can put your hands down, man. You didn't get it the first time. You're not gonna get it now, okay? It's time to move on. All right. Thank you. Thanks. Look, I know what I'm gonna do. Like, my round of applause if you've been to a live magic show before. Let me know if you have. That's a lot of you. Yeah, thanks. Well, look, I do these things all the time, and people always think that you use plans or you have setups of people in the audience, and I don't want people to think that. So, look, I'm just going to find out. What's your name, ma'am? Eileen. How are you doing, Eileen?
Fine.
Eileen, do you believe in mind reading, ESP, all that kind of stuff?
Yes.
Yes. Well, Eileen, here's what we're going to do. Well, there's a lot of non-believers around, but I'm going to do this with you. And if I was to do this with you, you'd have to believe that it was true, right?
Yes.
All right. Eileen, are you familiar with a packet of playing cards?
Yes.
Okay. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to think of any card in the whole deck, any card at all, and let me know when you have one.
Okay.
Have you got one?
Mm-hmm.
At this point, is there any way that I could know the card you're thinking of?
No.
That'd be impossible, right?
Yes.
Eileen. Okay. This is a prediction that I sealed yesterday. Now, what I want you to do... I didn't see it. So here's what we're going to do. In a nice, loud voice, so that everyone can hear, what is the card you were thinking of?
King of Spades.
The King of Spades. Ladies and gentlemen, would you be absolutely amazed if the King of Spades was in here?
Yes. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen... the King of Spades! Yeah! Some of these are just for me. Look, I tell you what, if I was to do that and it worked, Eileen, no one in the audience would believe me because they would have thought I would have just chosen you. So I'd like to actually do this, but with someone completely at random. And I know you probably... Thank you. We're just going to need one of you, and I'm going to let Ellen choose who that person is. Yeah.
The woman that's standing up with the floral dress and the little gray sweater on right there? Yes, you.
Right there,
how about
okay.
that? Is that good?
That, oh, it's not
did
for me.
Did she you... stay there?
No, I think just stay over there for me. Just stay
do
over there.
Do not approach us.
Oh, she... Here's what we're going to do. What's your name?
Stephanie.
Was that Stephanie?
Stephanie, I think she said.
Stephanie, yeah, here's what we're going to do.
You can stay there, Stephanie. It's okay.
Yeah.
You can go back to where your seat is so you're not blocking the woman with your... That woman is, like, looking around you.
Ellen,
I can
you
say
saw
ass.
The...
It's TBS. I... Ass. All right. Do I walk away? What do I do?
No, look here. We got the prediction on the table over here. I'm
okay.
just going to go down to it, if you don't mind. Now, Stephanie, we've never met before. Is that correct?
Correct.
Very good. Just like we rehearsed. Now, No, Stephanie, here's what we got. This is the prediction that I have over here. And what I want you to do, Stephanie, is watch closely and listen carefully. Can you just touch it, feel it, make sure that it is completely sealed? Is that right? Here's what I have. Inside here is the prediction. Now, every single card in this deck is face up. Every single card, except one, which is face down.
Okay.
And believe it or not, Stephanie, it's the card that you are about to think of.
Oh.
Now, here's something you need to know, Stephanie. I can't change the card that's face down. All I can do is manipulate your thoughts and make you say what I want you to say. Here's how I'm going to do that. In just a second, I'm going to say three words. Those three words will trigger off in my subconscious, make you start thinking of certain cards. Then you're going to get to a card, you're going to go, oh, there's no way he's going to think of that. Then you're going to change your mind because you're going to try to be clever. Then you're going to go, oh, there's no way he's going to think of that. Then I'm going to open the prediction. All the cards will be face down except one card. It'll be your card. The crowd will go wild. It'll be awesome. Are you ready, Stephanie?
Yes.
Don't think of the card until I say the words, okay. Pineapple. Candelabra. Potato. Have you got a card in mind?
Yes.
For the first time, so that everyone can hear, what is the card you were thinking of?
Six of diamonds.
The what?
The six of diamonds.
The six?
Yes.
Do you want to change your mind? The six of diamonds.
Yes.
I've done that 51 other times. It hasn't worked once. This is an exciting night.
It's great. I want Nick to come over
and see
this.
Yeah, bring him over. We're going to play a game of poker. Come on over, Nick.
Hi.
Yeah. Here's what we're going to do. Now, people always think I cheat when I play cards. Do you play cards, Nick?
Kind of.
Kind of?
I'm all right.
It's okay. It doesn't matter if you're good or bad. I'm going to teach you.
Okay.
Because I'm going to cheat playing you. I'm going to show you how this works. Watch very closely. I'll do it as slow as I can. First thing I want you to see, though, is that all the cards are different. No two cards are alike. Now, people always think I cheat when I play cards, because I do. But you can't cheat when you go to a casino, because people are always touching and cutting the cards. But when we're over here, I'm going to get you to cut the cards to make it impossible for me to know where you're going to do that. So, Ellen, would you just cut first for me, please? Fantastic. And could you lean forward, Nick, and just give the cards a cut? Fantastic. What I want to do is tell you a little story. It's one of my favorite stories. I think you're going to like it. Because I was out the other night, and I met up with a couple of girls. There were two redheads. I was chatting to them in front of them. I was about 1, 2, 3 minutes. I met up with their friends. They were two brunettes. They said, "What's your name?" I said, "It's James with a J. Don't forget that." They said, "Rightio, James, where are you headed tonight?" I said, "I'm not too sure. It's a place called 673 King Street." I said, "Sounds like a plan." They said, "There's a cover charge, though, of $25. I said, $25? They said, "Yep, $25. You with me so far?"
Good. Yeah.
At this point, my phone rang, right? So I cut in my pocket to find my phone. When I did, do you know what I said? I said, "Hello, James speaking." My friend said, "James, where are you headed tonight?" And I said, "I'm not too sure. It's a place called 700 and something King Street." Now, the girls knew that was wrong. They said, "No, no, no. It's 673 King." I said, "I'm sorry, Nick. I've actually got that wrong, mate. It's 673 King. He said, "I'll be there soon. Is there a cover charge?" You remember how much it was, folks? That's right. He said, "All I've got on me is 10. I said, "Don't lie." He goes, "Okay, I've got 40, but that's all I've got. Can you lend me some money?" I said, "No problem." He said, "James, you're a good person." Now, at this point, I rock up inside the Chicago Theater, but nobody's trusting me, especially you, Nick. So you cut the cards for me. Go ahead. And you said, "James, let's play poker." I said, "Sure, mate. What would you like?" You said, "I'd love a full house." I said, "What with?" You said, "Two fours and 3/8". I said, "I'll see what I can do." Ellen came over there. She wanted 4 9s, which is a pretty good hand as well. I wanted you to win, Nick, so you asked for the 4 aces with an 8. That's 1, that's 2, that's 3, that's 4. You went to go take all the money from the table because you thought you won, and I said, "What the hell are you doing?" You said James, you couldn't possibly beat that. I said, the only thing that does, mate, is a straight flush. That's what I've got, and that's my story.